Amen, and good morning, everyone. Good morning. I am thankful that you guys are here with us this morning. My name's Josh. I'm the preaching pastor here, and we have baptisms this morning. Amen? Yes, that's good. So if I could invite everybody that's coming up to get baptized, and you can come up this direction here and just stand on the stage, that'd be great. So we are very thankful that you're here with us this morning on Palm Sunday. Baptism is one of our favorite things to do here at church. And I just want to talk a little bit about what's going on and why we do baptisms. If you're new with us this morning, I can just give you a little bit of idea. Okay, come on down. Come on down. I don't bite. Okay, there we go. Just a quick overview of baptism. You know, why do we do baptisms at Living Waters? Well, we do it because it's commanded in Scripture. So the Great Commission, Jesus said to make disciples of all nations and baptize them in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. So this is part of just obedience to the Great Commission, obedience to Jesus. It's a wonderful thing when believers get baptized. It's an outward reflection of an inward reality. So these individuals are already saved. They're not getting saved in the waters, right? They're already saved. They're giving their testimonies of what led them to believe in Jesus Christ for their salvation, his death, burial, and resurrection. So it's an outward expression of an inward reality. And let's face it, it is a spiritual victory. Baptism is a wonderful spiritual victory, especially in the unseen realm. I often say privately and in smaller groups, baptism is like punching Satan in the face. Can I get an amen? It's always good to do that. It's a story of God's victory, and certainly the church celebrates. It's a sign of church health when you have people coming to Christ and getting baptized. So this is a really exciting time for us this morning. For those of you who are new believers, and there are several of you who are brand new Christians and you're watching this, this is a really good preview for you of your baptism by God's grace when you're ready to get baptized as a Christian. And for those of you who are thinking about it, contemplating it, it's a good thing for you to see this with your own eyes. And if you've been saved for a while, all right, and you've been a believer for a while, this is a great day to remember, amen? This is a great day for you to remember your baptism and what God did in your life. So this morning, we are privileged to have Braden Sathanarath share his testimony. We've got Cameron Heitkamp, and we have Tracy Steiner. So we're excited to have them share their testimony. Without further ado, I'm going to give the microphone to Rob. Actually, I'm going to give it to Rob first. Right. And Rob's going to introduce Rob.
Okay, I get to introduce Braden. Braden and I, we met last summer on our way up to IRBC, Regular Baptist Camp. And then I got to see how God just designed, it seemed, the whole week just to reach Braden. And so it was so cool to watch. It was so cool to see. And so I'll let Braden share his story.
That's a lot of faces. All right. My name is Braden. I've been going to Living Waters for about a year now, and I've learned a lot in that short time. I was raised in a Buddhist household all my life. The Buddhist teaching was that human life is one of suffering, and that meditation, spiritual and physical labor, and good behavior are the ways to achieve enlightenment. I was raised very well and very blessed to have such amazing and loving parents. Before Christ, I wasn't as caring to others, I wasn't as patient with people, and I was struggling a lot with sin, which I didn't know about at the time. Last spring, I started talking to a girl, whose name is Bree. She and her family attend Living Waters. She's very involved with the church and has already sparked my interest in Christ. We spoke about our beliefs, and she suggested that I attend church with her. I agreed because I enjoyed spending time with her. When I went to church with her, I was pleasantly surprised by the friendliness of the community, the service was good, and the singing was nice. After attending a few more times, Bree had invited me to attend church camp. I agreed, and I found the camp to be a really fun experience. During camp, we had a meeting where I noticed that everyone was socializing with each other, and no one was being excluded. In the evening service, we heard from a speaker named Nathan Beckman. He's a missionary out in Thailand, and he spoke with his wife, who was from Thailand. I was interested in what she had to say, as I could understand her speaking Thai. She talked about her testimony with Christ and how she came from a Buddhist household as well. Her story resonated with me for a long time, so I asked Pastor Rob if there was any way I could speak to the Beckmans, and later that week, we set up a meeting. We talked about how Ma'am was nervous about coming out to her family as a Christian because of the chance of being abandoned by her family or her decision to be disapproved of, which is my worry as well. However, in the end, she came out of it a better person and also converted her mother to be a Christian as well. And we ended the conversation with a prayer that my parents would be open to the idea of their son becoming a Christian. camp opened up my eyes to living in Christ, what it does to people, and how it changes them. Now looking back, God's timing was perfect. It happened to be Beckman's first time speaking at a camp, and it was my first time attending one. While at camp, I wanted to accept Jesus as my Lord and Savior, but I was worried about what my parents would say. So I told Pastor Rob I would talk to my parents once we got back, so I did just that. And once we got back to Living Waters, I got out of the van, hugged my mom, and she asked me about what I learned, and whatever I now believe in, she was in full support of, and I couldn't have been happier. In Mark chapter 11, verse 24, it says, "Therefore I tell you, whatever you ask for in prayer, believe that you've received it, and it will be yours." I received my prayer. God answered my prayer. I was so happy to hear my mom say that. I then texted Pastor Rob what my mom said and asked if he could pray me through the process of being saved by Christ. So we did just that. I accepted Jesus as my Savior that Sunday after coming back from camp. Everyone was happy for me, and to be honest, I am pretty sure I was the happiest person in church that day. I've come a long way since then. Now knowing that the Spirit lives within me, I've noticed a shift in my desires. I have a newfound purpose to live for Jesus and strive to deepen my faith. As I continue to grow in my journey, I hope to learn more about myself and my beliefs and strengthen my relationship with God.
Amen. That's awesome. I'm not sure I can follow that up at all, but praise the Lord, he does. So really thankful. I met Cam probably a year and a half, 2 years ago when we have a ministry called Gospel Center Recovery that meets on Friday nights at the Door of Faith through the GCR there. Cam came to the GCR there for several weeks, and we just kind of became friends and started kind of hanging out then. And then he ended up kind of coming and ended up being a part of Living Waters Fellowship. So we're really thankful that he's here, and I'll just let him talk about his journey and his relationship with the Lord. So,
thank you, Dave. It's good to be here, and thanks for everybody else for being here, too. Praise Jesus. My name is Cameron Heitkamp. My journey with the Lord has been pretty turbulent. I was raised, I wasn't absent from knowing of God. I was raised by Lutherans. My grandparents were big in their Lutheran church in Fort Dodge, so I was aware of the presence of God, and I did a lot of praying, but I really didn't understand or comprehend exactly what that was supposed to be or what that looked like. You know, it's one of those things where I prayed often, but usually in times of trouble, you know, it was a one-sided relationship there. When I hit my teens, my parents were having serious problems, and they started getting into drugs, and unfortunately, it wasn't too much longer, so did I. I had a lot of anxiety growing up because of the things that were going on at home, and drugs and alcohol became my favorite thing. I loved them far and above beyond just about anything else, and that continued. And long story short, for about the next 30 years, drugs and alcohol were my life. And, you know, I just worked on, you know, I was really big into a very prideful person, and I did a lot of good things. However, finally, after being arrested more times than I can count in my life for violence, drug possession, OWIs, I found myself in 2019 being sent to prison. I had gotten into a massive car wreck. I hit a telephone pole, severely injured myself, and there I was. I'm sitting in prison, and I was absolutely broken. I had finally come to the end of myself. I mean, I didn't know what to think. I didn't know what was coming next. I had nothing. I was so broken that I finally realized just exactly how much I needed Jesus. And it was just it wasn't a coincidence that the Brothers in Blue, a Christian organization, came into the prison like a weekend or two after I had arrived there. And we praised Jesus, me and a whole bunch of other inmates and some true followers of Jesus who cared about us, cared about who we were and where we were at in prison. And that's what we did. And I tell you what, life has never been the same since. Since then, I've been coming to Living Waters for about 5 months now. I've been to several different churches throughout the time, and it's still been turbulent, but it's never been the same. I've been relieved of a lot of the things that were plaguing me before, especially the anxiety, and today I have true hope. You know, and it's good to be here. And what I really am, I'm up here today to do is just to, I know it's not saving me, but what I want to do is I just want to you know, get my heart right and even, you know, get even more focused on Jesus, because it's a tough thing to do, you know, and it's hard to stay focused. But all I can do is just thank God and thank Jesus, because to be honest with you, I have absolutely no, I shouldn't be here, the life that I've lived. You know, I shouldn't. But, you know, because of Jesus, here I am. And just, I praise God. Mm-hmm.
And this is Tracy Steiner, and we met Tracy this summer, and it's been a wonderful, wonderful journey. You have a lot to share, so can I hold your towel while you share? There you go. All right. I am happy to be her towel holder as she shares her testimony with you.
Good morning.
Right there.
A little bit closer.
There you go.
Oh,
yep.
Boy.
Right here, Tracy, right here.
I want these people
here
to hear me. Yeah. Okay. I was born April 26th. You're not very important. I was born in California. At the age of 6, we moved to Fargo, North Dakota. At the age of 7, I made my first Holy Communion. I thought my life was great. I had God in my life, my mom and my dad and my baby brother. At the age of 10, my life changed dramatically. My mom walked out of my life, and my brothers left us with my dad. I felt so abandoned. A few months later, my brother was killed. I was outside playing with a neighbor kid. I was in the garden pulling weeds, checked on my brother as I was instructed a few moments later, neighbor comes running with my brother's shoes and said that was all that was left of him. At the age of 6, he was gone. He was dead, being hit by a drunk driver. So in a deep desperation and blaming myself for my brother's death for many years, I started questioning God. Why this? Why that? Never felt any comfort or protection. Never felt or always felt for many years that everything was my fault. Oh, thank you. that I should have died instead of my brother. School came and went. I finally made it to high school, where I decided I was going to join the service and get out of Fargo, North Dakota. I ended up in Norfolk, Virginia, where eventually I met my children's three children's father. I would have stayed, or I would have to say, my children were and are my blessings and saved my life from their dad and gave me strength to get out of a horrible situation where I almost died twice. In his hands. I moved back to North Dakota and had many trials and tribulations, one of which was horrific and once again abandoned by my mom and dad, which my biological dad, my stepdad was amazing. And again, a test of faith and questioning God on why I had to go through all of this myself. I always put on a happy face and a lot of pretending to be happy when I was slowly dying inside. A couple times. I wanted to take my own life. because I felt alone and not loved. I was put on, what was that last
name?
Anxiety and depression medicine for many, many years to mask everything going on. About 6 years ago, I finally had made peace about my brother, and what had happened was not my fault. Within the last couple of years, I had been thinking to myself, I need a change. I need God in my life. I needed something. I kept getting invited to churches and events and always made excuses, whether it was work or just some other crazy notion. I felt I just wasn't ready, even though I knew that I needed to get right with God and Jesus. God invited once again to come to a church called Living Waters. At this time, I was like, okay, and asked a friend and soon to be my husband to come with. This was July of 2023. Everything felt so right. In a short period of time, I came off my meds. In August of 23, I was saved by God, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit. And living and walking by their grace and love. My life has never been better. I had just had enough one day, sat on the back porch at the table and said, I've had enough. Please, God, take over. And it was at that time that I repented my sins and personally believed in Jesus' life, death, and resurrection. Since then, I have had so much peace and love. I have also come to the conclusion that by God's grace and love, that I have been able to conquer all the tribulations in my life. Oh yes, I still have my challenges in life, but I know now that I don't walk alone anymore. Amen. I thank God and Jesus every day for a new day to walk with them and learn the word. I'm thankful to Brandon for his perseverance in inviting me to Living Waters. And of all the wonderful pastors, I'm thankful Don and his willingness to help me learn and walk with me through my new life, faith in God, Jesus. God bless everyone. Yeah.
Okay, so we're going to hand the microphone back to Rob, and if we could have a couple deacons come up here, that'd be great, just to kind of help with towels and transitions and stuff. That'd be great.
All right, Braden, I'll let you start taking your shoes off and start making your way into... Yeah, so Braden, watching God work in Braden's life over that week was at camp was so amazing to see. I went up to Nate Beckman, the missionary that was in Thailand, and he had come back and was preaching at camp that week. And Nate Beckman, I said, "How many have you ever preached here before? How many times have you preached before?" He goes, "Rob, this is the first time I've ever come to IRBC to preach." And so, like, it was such a designed week by God to reach Braden. And that's what God does, right? God designs things in our lives to reach us. And it's cool to see.
Thank you.
just so excited about how the Lord's working in Cam's life and just being able to baptize him and walking through this journey with him has just been really special and just been awesome to be able to see the Lord just grow and change somebody and leave that life of addiction and drugs and alcohol. Amen. We all have addictions, right? We're all addicted to something. And the Lord just breaks those chains of addictions in our life, and it's so incredible to see that and the privilege to walk through people and to counsel people and through that and just to walk along them in that journey. Just so thankful.
Amen. I have a microphone on my face, so I can talk while we do this without having to worry about microphones. So, Tracy, this is awesome. It's a beautiful moment. You can go ahead and get in. And as Tracy gets in, it's been a real privilege and it's been a real honor.
I might just stay in here forever.
You want to stay? Temperature is good. Good job, Pastor John. Yes, Pastor John. Thank you. So it's a real honor to be in this moment. Tracy, we were really excited about you when you first came to visit. We're like, man, we get to baptize and see the Menards lady get saved. Amen? Like, this is so great. In South Des Moines, those of you who frequent Menards, you know this is a big deal. This is a really big deal. And just to see how God has worked in your life, to meet Don, to see this beautiful thing that the Holy Spirit has done to cause you to be born again, and I just am so excited for you, and it's an honor to baptize you, okay? Okay, let's pray together. Father, thank you for Tracy. Lord, what an amazing testimony of grace. Lord, you have taken her through some deep waters, some hard roads, and yet, Lord, those roads have led to Jesus Christ and his healing grace and his saving mercy, and we are so grateful for Tracy. Lord, we pray that she would grow not to just be a Christian, but to have to be a woman of faith that has a godly legacy, Lord, for the rest of her days. So, Jesus, we pray that this would be the beginning of great fruit-bearing and wonderful obedience to Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord, for her courage to share her testimony. Thank you for the sweet spirit that she shared it with, Lord. Thank you for your grace in her life. God, we pray and ask that you would bless her now in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, Tracy, based off of your testimony of faith in Jesus, yep, go ahead and move up a little bit. I want to bang your head back there. We now baptize you. It's my privilege to baptize you based off of your testimony and faith in Christ in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.